शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदागुश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महा तदेवान्नमत्तो निति मे निश्चितामतिः। सो तत्व दृष्टि टोल्ड टू द गुरु दैट आई डू अंडरस्टैंड दिस प्रपंच इज मिथ्या देयर बाय संसार दुख इज मिथ्या हाउएवर देयर इज दुख प्रतीति एंड जस्ट लाइक मिथ्या स्वप्न कैन कॉज ट्रबल I am afflicted, and just as one has to have some upaya for nightmares also, so that the mithya dukkha in swapna also goes away. Similarly, I would like to know the upaya for the samsarika dukkha to go away, although it is mithya. Ataha tan nivartanam icchami, tasmat tan nivritti upayam krupaya vada. भोहो इति शिष्य प्रश्न एंड द आंसर वाज ऑलरेडी गिवन द आंसर वाज ऑलरेडी गिवन आई विल रिपीट फॉर योर सेक सेज द गुरु एंड ही सेज व्हाट इज द मोक्ष साधनम अहम सच्चिदानंद अनंत अद्वितीय असंग ब्रह्म स्वरूप एव अस्मि इति एवं निश्चय एव ज्ञानमित्युच्यते And that jnana, how do you hold on? Etadeva jnanam asukter amrutescha nirantaram abhyasyamanam moksha sadhanam. Continuously being in that nitaram sthiti, that is nishtha, in that jnana aham brahmasviti jnanam, in that jnana staying continuously nirantaram asukter amrutehe, that is called as moksha sadhana. That alone is moksha sadhana, na anyat. किंचिदपि नथिंग एल्स कैन बी मोक्ष साधना तदिदं ज्ञानं पूर्वमेव उपदिष्ट वानस्मि इति गुरुराह आई हैव ऑलरेडी टॉट दिस टू यू अर्लियर दिस इज जस्ट अ रिपीटेशन फॉर योर सेक हैव श्रद्धा राइट इट वाज सेड श्रद्धा भक्ति पुरस्सरम यू शुड हैव श्रद्धा एंड भक्ति बिफोर दिस ज्ञान स्टेबिलाइजेस अदरवाइज संशय विल रिमेन एंड ऑब्स्टैकल्स विल नॉट लेट द ज्ञान फ्रक्टिफाई ज्ञानम एव अज्ञान नाशकम न कर्म उपासना जी इफ देर इज एनी डाउट दैट कर्म और उपासना और टुगेदर कर्म एंड उपासना कैन लीड टू मोक्ष और मोक्ष इज अज्ञान नाश एंड अज्ञान नाश कैन टेक प्लेस बाय एनी अदर मीन्स इफ दैट इज अ मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग इफ दैट इज द एक्सपेक्टेशन इवन दैट इज अ मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग हे सौम्य अस्य जगत उपादान कारणम अज्ञानम अज्ञान इज दि मटेरियल कॉज ऑफ दिस प्रपंच अस्य अज्ञानस्य नाशम अनु तत्कार्यम सर्वं दृश्यम जगत स्वयमेव विनश्यति सो अस्य अज्ञानस्य नाशम अनु वंस दिस अज्ञान नाश टेक्स प्लेस विच इज ए उपादान कारण फॉर जगत देन व्हाट विल हैपन अनु फॉलोइंग दैट तत्कार्यम अज्ञान कार्यम Is this jagat? Sarvam jagat. Idam jagat. Drishyam jagat. Which is, there is a pratiti about. Which is drishya prapancha. Swayam eva vinashyati. It will go away on its own. Because Karananashe, Karyanashaha. Upadana and Nasha is what? See, it is Drishya Prapancha. Adarshanam. This what is seen, there is a pratiti as real. Once one understands like a desert, like mirage water in the desert, there may be a pratiti of mirage water, but once you know it is mirage, then you don't consider it as real water. One wouldn't hanker after it. So Ragadesha goes away. Ragadesha driven participation in these samsara karma goes away. Although the drishya remains as drishya. So nasha is what? Adarshanam. Nasha adarshane. So adarshana, the nanj there is not absence, abhavarthe. There will be no, it does not mean that there will be no pratiti. There will be a pratiti, but the pratiti will be seen as pratiti only. It's an apparent reality, which is no reality. You don't go after some kalpita or drishya just because it is drishya does not make it real. And once you know it is only drishya, it is not real, then there won't be hankering after it. That is the idea when he says, asya ajnanasya nashamanu, following the nasha of the ajnana, which is karana, tatkarya, tatkaryam sarvam drishyam jagat swayam eva vinashyati, upadana nashanantaram tatkaryasya stitya yogat. Because, why? Because sthiti is not possible of karya once its karana goes away, which is upadana karana. Had it been nimitta karana, then you can say nimitta karana goes away. The potter makes the pot and he goes away. He does not come along with you when you buy the pot. What comes along is the upadana karana, the clay. You cannot separate the upadana karana from the karya. You cannot say, I'll take the karya, the pot home, but I do not want clay. Clay comes along. But you can say nimitta karana, even if you want, he may not come. The potter is separate. In the case of the prapancha, Ishvara is abhinna nimitta upadana karana. So wherever there is prapancha, there alone the upadana karana, avidya, maya, shakti of Ishvara is there, which cannot be separated from Ishvara. So who is nimitta karana also? So chetana nimitta karana and jada maya shakti, which is the upadana karana, both are together mixed up as though, and they come along as karana with the karya, prapancha. But once the avidya or maya, which is the shakti which veils, avarana shakti which veils the swarupa of Ishvara as you, then once that goes away, then this prapancha is just a superimposition. The prapancha includes the body, mind, sense complex at the individual as well as the total level. So the differences created by the upadhi at the universal and the individual level goes away as real. It is no longer real because the projection, although it continues, we don't consider it as real once the avarana goes away. So that is the idea here. Upadana nasha, when the maya shakti or the avidya which is there, that goes away, then its karya will not stay. Tasya ajnanasya nashaha tu jnana matrena jayate. And how will this nasha take place, ajnana nasha? Only through jnana, because it is virodarthe nanj. Ajnana is jnana virodhi. Natu karma upasanadivihi sadhanantarehi. Anyehi sadhanehi na jayate. Nashaha. Ajnana nasha na jayate. Like what sadhanas, other sadhanas like karma and upasanas cannot take away ajnana. Yato jnanam eva sakshad ajnana virodhi na karma upasanadikam. Karma and upasanas are not opposed to ajnana. In fact, they are ajnana karya. Karma is ajnana karya, not it. You can't see it directly at times, but it is the triad that we have seen multiple times, ajnana, kama, karma. Then karma phala keeps ajnana continuing. Then again, raga dvesha in the form of kama continue, and then karma. So karma, upasana is manasika karma. Karma, by karma, generally when we say karma, it is kayika. Manasika may be a part of the karma as well. However, main part is the kayika karma. Upasana also may have some kayika as secondary, but then main anga is the manasika karma, upasana. So karma, upasana, both are gross and subtle karma. And that being the result, karma being result of kama, which is a result of avidya, an effect of avidya, therefore they are ajnana karya. Ajnana karya is not opposed to ajnana. Therefore, sakshad ajnana virodhi jnanam eva natu karma upasanadikam. Yata grahantara vidyamanam tamaha kena api vyaparena anivartyam api kevala prakashena nivartyate tatha ajnana rupam nibidam tamaha jnanatmaka prachanda prakashena eva nivartyeta. Natu kena chedapi sadhanantarena. Example given is, if there is tamaha, there is pitch darkness inside the house, the windows are closed, curtains are drawn, there is no scope for light to enter, then grahantara vidyamanam tamaha, the darkness which is there within the house, how will it go away? Kena api vyaparena anivartyam api. If you try to take away darkness through any karma, it will not go away. You can't draw it away. Except for prakasha. Kevala prakashena nivartyate. Now this example may seem funny, you know. Nobody even tries to take away darkness by any other means. Even a kid knows that you have to light a lamp. There should be prakasha. Why is this example given? Because this is the kind of ridiculous thinking that should come in. Ridiculous as in the other thinking. That karma and upasana can lead to ajnana nasha. That thinking should be seen as ridiculous as trying to take away tamaha through any other means than prakasha. That is why such examples are given. We can laugh at this example, but can we laugh at the thinking that I need karma and upasana for moksha? If I cannot laugh at this example, at the exemplified, what I am doing, I am trying to attain moksha through karma and upasana. I say that, okay, what I see, you have to see moksha meaning what? Sukha rupa moksha. Even at a part of moksha, a part of sukha, a little sukha, if I am trying to get that through karma, because I am seeking that in vishaya. Vishaya sukha is sought by many of us. We continue to seek it. What does that tell us? That ananda rupa, me, my swarupa is ananda rupa, is lost on me. I am searching for that ananda sukha elsewhere. Through karma. Can be upasana also. Laukika karma itself. Laukika karma tells us that I am looking for sukha, vishaya sukha. And that should be seen as ridiculous as trying to take away darkness without light through any other means. Unless that happens, this example, we cannot laugh at, because our pursuit of ananda, sukha, this seeking of sukha, which is basically seeking for moksha, is as ridiculous. Tatha ajnana rupam nibidam tamaha, gada tamaha, jnanatmaka prachanda prakashene eva nivartyeta. It will go away by jnana, and not just little jnana, paroksha jnana, aparoksha sakshatkara should take place. It should culminate in nishtha, therefore prachanda prakashene eva nivartyeta. Comparable to prakasha is the jnana, natu kena chidapi sadhana antarena. Through another sadhana, it will not go away, whatever it is. He somya द्वैत रूपम जगत यथा निशेषम निवर्तेत तथा अहम ते साधनम उपादिशम। आई हैव टॉट यू, गुरु सेज लंगलकारा द्वैत द्वैत रूपम जगत, हे सौम्य दिस द्वैत रूप जगत विच इज देर विच यू थिंक इज देर देर इज अ प्रतीति यथा निशेषम निवर्तेत। निशेष निवृत्ति इज पॉसिबल ओनली थ्रू ज्ञान, अदरवाइज इट विल बी टेम्पररी निवृत्ति थ्रू कर्म। इफ यू ट्राई टू टेक अवे सम द्वैत इट विल गो अवे बट इट कम बैक अगेन बिकॉज इट हैज अ पोटेंशियल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कारण विच विल कंटिन्यू बिकॉज द रूट कारण अज्ञान कंटिन्यूज दि अदर कारण विल कंटिन्यू एंड विल कीप ऑन थ्रोइंग अप दुख एवरी नाउ एंड देन। वी हैव टू डील विद द रूट कॉज and then alone once that goes away nishesham nivarteta jagat which is vikarya dvaita rupam jagat yatha nishesham nivarteta tatha aham te sadanam upadisham. What is sadana? Nirantara jnana, nirantara jnana nishtha, so nitaram sthiti in that jnana which is aikya rupa jnana. Tad etan manasi dharayan punah punar yuktibhihi anuchintaya. It should be manana siddha. You cannot land on nishtha without manana siddhi. So manasi dharayan, holding on to that jnana in the mind as taught by the shruti and acharya, and punah punar yukti vihi anuchintaya. Think about it using yuktis, using logic, which is also taught by the shruti, revealed by the shruti. As long as you land on the same conclusion that the Shruti is trying to show you, Aikya, you can use any methodology. You may not be able to help others see through that methodology the way you see Aikya. You may not be able to show others. But as long as you have no doubts and others' questions don't lead to doubts in your mind, so long that prakriya is fine. You don't need to explain it to others. Can you by any mechanism land on aikya as taught in the shruti? Then the upaya is fine, yukti is fine. The yukti should be perfect only when you are trying to debate with others or you are trying to, you know, establish something else for another. For yourself, is it convincing? Then hold on to it as long as the yukti leads to aikya as taught in the shruti. Therefore punah punar yukti bhi anuchintaya tato api samshayo yadi syad yathecham pruchha iti guru rah. Even then, if you still have doubts, please ask. So don't hold on to your doubts. If you hold on to your doubts, it will not be manana siddha jnana, it will be Shruti says it, Guru says it, I do not know. Even if you don't utter these words or think these words, I do not know. Just by saying Shruti says it and the Guru says it or others, you know, Advaitin, Acharya said, this Grantha says it, it will still be Paroksha. Paroksha Jnana will not bring Sakshatkara, it will not give Moksha. So पूर्वोपदिष्ट विषय आक्षेप समाधानानि. Now the doubts are raised. जीव ब्रह्मणोर अभेद निरूपणम्. So explanation is given for अभेदा between जीव and ब्रह्मा and जीव ब्रह्म अभेद विषय तत्वदृष्टि प्रश्नः. तत्वदृष्टि ask question regarding the ऐक्य between अभेदा between जीव and ब्रह्मा. These are the topics covered next. गुरु उपदेशम it should be गुरु not गुरु गुरु उपदेशम संग्रहेण अनूद्य शिष्यः स्वशंकां सूचयति. गुरु हैज आस्क्ड, यू नो, गुरु हैज सेड इन द एंड, यू आस्क मी व्हाट एवर डाउट्स यू हैव. सो बिफोर आस्किंग द क्वेश्चन ब्रीफली यू हैव टू, बिफोर आस्किंग द क्वेश्चन, यू नो, यू कैन जस्ट डस नॉट ब्लाइंडली आस्क क्वेश्चंस. टू ask the question also, you should establish what you have understood, whether, and this is true in, especially in debates, when you are raising a doubt or a purva paksha, even an objection, then you have to explain what the other has said, what you have understood. You have to summarize it. So shishya, what is he doing? Sangrahena anudya, gathering whatever has been taught briefly, then he raises doubts. So if there is an error in the understanding itself, that can be corrected before taking a doubt, or the doubt may be invalid considering the misunderstanding earlier, which can be corrected. He swamin jagat karanam ajnanam tasya ajnanasya tat prayukta jagatascha nashah jnaneneva jayate. This is sangraha. So shishya has understood tattva drishti se jagat karana is ajnana. I understand tasya ajnanasya tat prayukta jagatascha, that ajnana and ajnana karya both have to undergo nasha. Nasha, and how will that nasha take place? Jnaneneva jayate iti bhavad upadishtam samyak avagachami. I have understood it completely, says tattva drishti. Parantu, however, samshaya is what, swashanka? Jagan mithya jiva ananda swarupaha atascha sa jivaha brahmanaha na bhinnaha iti bhavato upadishte arthe jagan mithyatvam jivasya ananda rupatvam cha avagachami. So he says jagat is mithya, jiva is ananda swarupa, and since jagat is mithya, which includes the jiva sharira, since that is mithya, jiva swarupa being ananda, that ananda swarupa is same as brahma, brahmananda, therefore jiva brahmana na bhinna iti bhavata upadishte arthe jagat mithyatam, whatever has been taught by you, in that jagat mithyatvam jivasya ananda rupatvam cha avagachhami. I understand in this manner, jivaha brahma abhinna iti aunshantu na avadharayami. However, see what have you said, jagat mithyatvam, what have you taught? Jagat is mithya, jiva is ananda swarupa, but finally jiva brahmana na bhinna. Overall I understood what you are saying. And in these teachings, what you have given, if I break them up, jagat mithya I understand, jiva ananda swarupa also I understand. But just because jiva is ananda swarupa and jagat is mithya, jiva brahma aikya I do not understand. Jiva brahma abhinnaha iti aunshantu na avadharayami. I do not understand. And this is the issue with dvaitins. Of course, they don't consider jagat as mithya. They take only one unit. Let's say jiva is ananda swarupa. They all agree that jiva is ananda swarupa. Not the way Advaitin says, because the jiva's ananda is still limited in dvaita Vedanta. Vedanta or any other dvaita. Anything other than Advaita, whether Vedanta or not, is all dvaita. Nayayikas, Vaisheshikas, Sankhyas, Yogis, Purva Mimamsakas, Bauddhas, Jainas, all are Dvaitins. Charvakas, all are Dvaitins. Then Vishishta Dvaitins, Bheda Bhedavadins, then Madhavas, Dvaita Vedantins. Then those who follow Vallabhacharya, all these, I mean, all these Shuddha Advaitins, all these have different notions of Advaita itself has been qualified by them. See, Vishishta Advaita. Vishishta Advaita is no Advaita. You cannot have Advaita and qualify it. Once you qualify it, is a Visheshana. Visheshana is different from the Visheshya. Therefore, Vishishta Advaita is not Advaita at all. It is a contradiction in terms. Then Shuddha Advaita. Then Dvaita Advaita, all these are contradiction in terms. Shuddha Advaita is not a contradiction in terms, but then Shuddha Advaita is actually Shuddha Dvaita. If you look at what they discuss, it is all Shuddha Dvaita, it is not Advaita. To say that there is real Dvaita Prapancha during Baddha Avastha and there is Advaita in Moksha Avastha, both being real, is Dvaita. It is not, there is nothing Shuddha about it. There is nothing Advaita about it either. Therefore, all these ideas are ideas are good on paper. Actually, not even good on paper. They are logically also incorrect. But their main idea is, for us, all of them are Dvaitins. We have to reject it wholesale because it is Shruti Virodha. Shruti Viruddha, all philosophies are Shruti Viruddha. All these are opposed to Shruti. So some, they do not agree of Jagat Mithyatam, but they say Ananda Swarupa, that is also segmented Ananda. But even if you give some concessions and say, okay, they accept that Jiva is Ananda Swarupa, and completely also, even if you give that concession, they do not agree with Jiva Brahma Aikya. So Tattva Drishti has the same issue. But he is advanced, so he knows Jagat is Mithya. Swapnavat Mithya, he understands. Jiva is Ananda Swarupa because all these are the pratiti which is there, dukkha pratiti is mithya. Therefore, jiva is ananda swarupa. Swarupata ananda rupa, atma. But aikya he does not understand. Brahmana abhinnaha, na bhinnaha is something which is a tall order, you know. Pooja Swamiji used to say, when there are all... if you think of attributes, although there are no attributes, Ishara has attributes. Saguna Brahma. Gunehi sa vartate iti saguna. So saguna Brahma. Ishara has attributes. Attributed Brahman. His attributes are so superior, you can't even imagine. And at the Jiva level, the attributed Atma, Pratyagatma with attributes, Avidya, who has Avidya, who is influenced by Maya Shakti, whereas Ishvara wields the Maya Shakti. He is not under the Maya Avarana. Avarana Shakti. He is not affected. Alpajna on one hand, Sarvajna on another hand. Alpa Shaktiman, Sarva Shaktiman. So, at all levels, there is Virodha. This fellow is a tiny guy with a small Sharira. Ishvara has Virat Sharira. Vishwarupa, where is the comparison? Comparison is not possible. There is, you cannot in the same breath even mention Jiva and Ishvara. So, talking about Aikya between them is like swallowing a pumpkin. This is what Pooja Swami uses. You know, the Guru offers a pumpkin to swallow, tells the Shishya, Tattvamasi, you are Ishvara. How is this Jiva supposed to swallow the pumpkin? It's not possible. So, jivaha brahma abhinnaha iti amushantu na avadharayami. I do not understand that part of aikya. But without this jnana, moksha is impossible. This aikya jnana itself is moksha karaka. Jiva jnana, jiva being different from anatma, meaning atma being different from anatma, I being separate from the shariratraya, is not going to give me moksha because yogis already have it. Sankhyas have it. They agree. They do not have aikya jnana. That's why samadhi is possible. Even if there is aikya in samadhi, just like in Shushupti, one wakes up after Shushupti into this dvaita prapancha as a baddha jiva. Similarly, after samadhi, a person would wake up to dvaita and continue as a samsari. Bereft of this Aikya Jnana, Samadhi will not help. Ajnani goes into deep sleep, Sushupti, as well as Samadhi as an Ajnani and comes out as an Ajnani. Jnani goes to deep sleep and Samadhi as a Jnani, comes out as a Jnani, remains a Jnani. Ajnani remains an Ajnani, Jnani remains a Jnani. Therefore, Jnana alone is the Upaya, Sakshat Moksha Sadhanam. Jiyo Brahma bhinna iti amusham tu na avadharayami tayor bheda shanka eva mi manasi parivartate. The doubt about duality continues, and once there is duality, doubt about my being different, if there is a doubt in aikya, then I have concluded that I am different from Brahma, thereby all sorts of dualities will pop up, which will lead to plurality. It's multiplicity. So, duality does not mean only two. Duality really means plurality. इति तत्व दृष्टि पृच्छति. सो ही आस्क्ड दिस क्वेश्चन टू गुरु. जीव ब्रह्मणो स्वरूप भेदात् तयोर ऐक्यम असंगतम इति शंका. बिकॉज स्वरूप भेद एग्जिस्ट बिटवीन जीव एंड ब्रह्म. स्वरूपता भेद इज देयर, देयरफॉर ऐक्य इज नॉट राइट. दिस आइडिया ऑफ ऐक्य इज असंगतम, इट इज इनवैलिड. इति शंका, दिस इज द डाउट दैट तत्व दृष्टि हैज. हे स्वामिन, अहम ही पुण्य पापयो कर्ता. सो आई हु यू कंसीडर और टीच एज बीइंग वन विद ब्रह्मा, आई एम द कर्ता ऑफ पुण्य पाप. तत्फल भूत जनन मरण सुख दुखादीनी अनुभवामि. फर्दर, सिंस आई एम कर्ता ऑफ पुण्य एंड पाप, दिस लीड्स टू जन्म मरण सुख दुख इत्यादि. विचार दि फल. सो पुण्य पाप फलभूत जन्म मरण सुख दुख ऑल दिस कंटिन्यू फॉर मी अनुभवामि. विचित्र रचना विशिष्टम जगन्मयी प्रतिभाति. एंड दिस वेराइटी, वॉट एवर लिटिल इज नोन अबाउट प्रपंच, इट इज स्टिल टेंडिंग टू इन्फिनिटी काइंड ऑफ वेराइटी. दैट काइंड ऑफ विशिष्ट जगत, विचित्र रचना विशिष्टम जगत मई प्रतिभाति. आई हैव प्रतीति ऑफ दिस प्रपंच इन मी विच इज सो वेरिड. जगत कारणीभूत मूलाज्ञान निवृत्तये अहम ब्रह्म विजिज्ञासे. एंड फर्दर, आई एम अ सीकर, आई एम अ साधक, आई एम अ मुमुक्षु, आई एम अ जिज्ञासु. आई वॉन्ट टू नो दिस प्रपंच कारण, जगत कारण. एंड देर बाय थ्रू ज्ञान ऑफ दिस कारण मोक्ष, मोक्ष ज्ञान भवति. देर फोर आई सी ज्ञान. सो विजिज्ञासे, ब्रह्म विजिज्ञासे, आई नीड ब्रह्म ज्ञान टू टेक अवे अज्ञान विच इज जगत कारण. जगत कारण इज ईश्वर हू हैज अज्ञान हैज शक्ति. देर फोर आई नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड अज्ञान ऑल्सो. आई नीड टू नो माई ईश्वर. So, moola ajnana nivritti has to take place for, and that can happen only through brahma jnana. Therefore, brahma vijnyase, visheshatah jnyase. I do not want to know brahma just like that. You know, what is brahma? Definition won't help me. I want to know beyond the definition, vishesha jnana. I need sakshatkara. Brahmanastu, on the other hand, brahmanastu punya papinastah. There is no punya and papa for brahma. It is only for me. Janma marana, which is the sukha dukha ityadi, which are phalabhuta. Punya papa phalabhuta. Janma marana sukha dukha adi klesha lesho api brahmano na sambhavati. Since he is not the karta, brahma is not the karta, brahma is not the bhokta even. But I am karta as well as bhokta of sukha dukha ityadi, janma marana. So opposition at that level also. Ata eva tasya jnya jnani ichha api. Since he has no sukha dukha adi klesha api, there is no reason for dukha nivritti and sukha prapti, because he is already ananda sarupa. So tasya brahmana jnana ichha api na sambhavati. There is no jnana ichha for brahma. Jnana ichha is for me. Tasman mama brahmanascha mithas sarupata bheda eva vartate. So sarupata bheda, mutually, mithaha. Mutually, there is difference between me and Brahma. Tataha dvayor aikyam naiva ghateta. Now, if mutually we are opposed to each other, how can there be aikya? Aikya is not possible. Yadyapi janmadi samsara paramarthatam mayyapi nastyeva tatapi mithyabhuta janma maranatmakah samsara mayi swapnavat bhrantya pratibhati. And don't think that I have not understood the teaching. Oh Guru, I have understood the teaching. Hey Guru, yadyapi janmadi samsara, janma marana sukha dukkhadi samsara, that is not there in me. Mayyapi paramarthata nasti. In reality, paramarthika drishti, it is not there in me. Still, tathapi mithyabhuta samsara, which you have taught, mithyabhuta samsara is there. Because I am drashta. He said, you are the drashta. For you, there is samsara. Only pratiti is there because you are the drashta. You are the adhara and adhishtana. So, mithyabhuta janmamaranatmaka samsara mahi swapnavat bhrantya pratibhati. Brahma does not have swapna even. Brahma does not have maranatmaka, janmamaranatmaka, mithyabhuta samsara also. However, I have swapna also. The example, and I have janmamaranatmaka samsara also, mithyabhuta. So the waking world continues like Swapna, but still continues. Whereas it is not there for Brahma. Brahmani tu tannaiva pratibhati. Brahma does not have this. Bhranti. I have Bhranti. He does not have Bhranti. Jiva Brahmanur ittham bheda sadbhavad. Paikyam na sambhavati. Since bheda continues to be there between Jiva and Brahma at all levels, however I analyze it, there are bhedas and more bhedas. Therefore, aikyam na sambhavati. Aikya is not possible. Ayancha prameyagata samshayaha. Prameyagata samshaya. Prameyagata samshaya is whatever is taught in the Shruti. Shruti is pramana. I am the pramatru there. Then, what Shruti teaches is prameya. Pramana gata samshaya is what the Shruti is teaching. Prameya gata samshaya is whether what is revealed by the Shruti is right. Whether it is applicable to me. So, pramana gata samshaya will go by Shravana. Prameya gata samshaya will go by Manana. That is the Vyavastha. Shrutya karma upasana vidhi balacha jiva brahma bheda shanka. Now, there is a question about Shruti itself. Shruti, does Shruti talk about karma upasana? Yes. So, Shrutya karma upasana vidhi balacha jiva brahma bheda shanka. If Shruti is talking about karma and upasana, who will do the karma and upasana? Jiva will do the karma upasana. If there is abheda, then how will Jiva, who is one with Brahma, how will he do upasana and karma? Can Shruti talk about such a thing? Shruti can never talk about such a thing. Since Shruti talks about karma and upasana, which have their basis in Dvaita, in Bheda. Jiva can do Brahma Upasana, can do karma to reach somewhere, Brahma Loka Ityadi. Thereby there is division. And since Shruti talks about it, this division has to be accepted, Bheda has to be accepted. This is an argument that Purva Pakshi will also give. Shruti will become Vyartha. Hey Swamin, mama samshayantaram api jayate. Now another doubt has popped up. What is it? Shrutya eva vakshyamana prakarana jiva brahmanor bheda pratipadyate. Shruti talks about bheda. And if you say, okay, it is karma kanda, I will give examples of Upanishad. So, Upanishad examples. Tattva Drishti has studied all this. You've seen all the shastras have been studied by all the three children. How much they have understood is a different story. But they have studied. At least there has been Shabda Jnana. Artha Jnana may not have been there. But they have studied in Gurukula as Brahmacharis. They have studied all this. Shrutyayo Vakshamana Prakarana Jiya Brahmanor Bheda Pratipadyate. Veda is revealed by Shruti. How? Dva Suparna Sayuja Sakhaya Samanam Vriksham Parishashvajate Tayoranya Pippalam Swadvatti Anashnananeo Abhichakashiti. So Mundaka Upanishad says this. And then Shvetashvatara Upanishad also. Itihi Shrutihi. This is a Shruti. Vedanta Vakya, Upanishad Vakya, Dva Suparna. There are two birds. Sayuja Sakhayaha Samanam Vriksham Parishashvajate. They are resting on the same tree. both the birds are, you know, close by, like friends. They are sitting on the same branch even of the tree. Samanam vruksham. Samanam is actually similar, can be taken similar or it can be the same also. Between them, tayoho anyaha, one of them, pippalam swadvatti. Pippala is the phala. In the pippala tree, pippala phala. The real fruit. In the example, it's a fruit. One bird is eating a fruit. Anyaha pippalam swadvatti. He has rasaswada in the pippala and eats that. He is a bhogi. One bird is a bhogi, partakes of the phala. Anyaha anashnan. Anashnan anyaha. Shatranta padam. The other, however, other bird, without eating the pippala, just watches over. Sakshi. Abhichakashiti. Watches over. What is this Bheda? This is an example. So the explanation given is Brahma, Ishvara, is sitting separately without being a bhogi. Meaning he is not a karta bhokta. He is not eating. Pippalam swadvatti. Here kartutvam is shown as well as bhoktrutvam. Because he is eating, there is a karma of eating. And since he is getting the pippala phala, it is also a result of the earlier karma. So both can be understood there or extended as kartrutva bhoktrutva is there for the jiva, who is the first bird. Whereas Ishvara is separate, who is watching over. He is neither the karta nor the bhokta. So Bheda is taught in the Shruti itself. And this is a favorite example of Dvaitins. Ayam arthaha. What is the meaning there? Buddhi rupe ekasmin vrikshe dho pakshino vasataha. In the exemplified, what is the vriksha? Buddhi is the vriksha. In the buddhi, same, ekasmin buddhi rupe vrikshe dvau pakshino vasataha. So Suparna are those who have wings. So pakshis who have wings, they are birds, who jivas, jiva and Ishvara there. Tau ubhavapi samana svabhavo. They have a, here it is said, sayuja sakhaya. So they have similar features, samana svabhava. Both are birds, both are expected to behave similarly. Tatra ekaha karma phala bhukta aparaha shuddha bhograhita asangaha san karma phala bhuktaram prakashayati. The other watches over, not only watches over, he makes the jiva act. Prakashayati there. He makes the jiva continue to be bhokta. How so? Karma phala data. Ishvara is a karma phala data. He watches over. He himself does not partake of the karma phala. He makes it possible for the jiva to have bhoga. Karma phala bhoga. Therefore, Ishvara Brahma apara is shuddha bhoga rahita. Whereas the jiva ekaha is karma phala bhokta. Anayoho karma phala bhukta jiva iti aparaha paramatma iti cha pratiyate. So it is seen from the same mantra, Shruti Gata mantra, that one is karma phala bhukta jiva, other is paramatma who is not karma phala bhukta. There is a difference between the two. Ityevam shrutyaeva jiva brahmanor bheda pratipadanat na tayor aikyam yuktam. Since Shruti herself shows the difference between the two, you cannot say there is aikya. Aikya is not possible. Kincha vede nana prakarani karmani upasanani cha tatra tatra katitani. Preceding this, there are so many karmas and upasanas also discussed in the Shruti. Veda itself, you cannot say it is not valid. Tani nirarthakani syuhu. They would be completely useless. Why? Jiva brahmanor ekatva abhyubhagami. If you accept Jiva and Brahma are one, then you cannot have aikya between the two, and whatever if you accept aikya between the two, then there cannot be karma and upasana which take bheda for granted. Only if there is all sorts of dualities, then only you will have karaka bheda. Once you have karaka bheda, then only karma and upasanas are possible. Otherwise you cannot have karma upasanas. But Shruti teaching karma and upasanas will become useless if Aikya is accepted. Where will this you know, karma and upasana be useful then? If aikya is being taught, it is teaching something which is useless. Tathahi. Now this is Sangraha Vakya which is elaborated. Tathahi jiva brahmano rekatvam kim brahmani jiva swarupantar bhavat. Now this aikya which is talked about, which you say is the main teaching of the Upanishads, whether it is brahmani jiva swarupantar bhavat. In Brahma, there is jiva swarupa antarbhava. In Brahma, so from the Brahma's perspective, there is aikya, jiva is one with Brahma. That is the ekatvam. Kimva or jive Brahma swarupa antarbhavat. Or is this aikya due to jiva having no difference from Brahma swarupa? So from the perspective of jiva is there aikya, or from the perspective of Brahma there is aikya? This is a simplistic way of putting. Brahmani jiva swarupantar bhava is there, or in jiva Brahma swarupantar bhava is there? Where will you put this oneness? I have oneness with Brahma, or does Brahma have oneness with me? Na ubhayata api sambhavati. So if you take from any perspective, it is not possible. In both ways, it is invalid. Brahmani jiva swarupantar bhava abhyupagame. The first paksha, prathama pakshe, brahmani jiva swarupantar bhava. If you say that, Brahma has jiva swarupantar bhava. Jiva swarupa is within Brahma. Then what will happen? Meaning what? Brahma is jiva. That's what it will mean. Is Brahma jiva, first paksha, or jiva Brahma? In Brahma, is there jivatvam? Or in jiva there is brahmatvam. This is another way to have a look at it. If you say brahmani jiva swarupantar bhava is there, meaning Brahma has jivatva. That is what it will amount to mean. Brahmani jiva swarupantar bhava abhyupagame jivasyeva brahmarupatvat. Then you have said jiva is Brahma. So jivasyeva brahmarupatvat karma upasanadi adhikari bhava adhikarya bhava prasangat. Then jiva is Brahma. So in brahmani jiva swarupantara bhava abhyupagami jiva seva brahma rupatvat karma upasanadi adhikarya bhava prasangat. There will be no adhikari, since Brahma has jivatvam, has jiva swarupa. Then jiva and Brahma are one. Then how can you have karma upasana? Because there will be no adhikari, because jiva is Brahma. Since jiva is Brahma, you cannot have adhikari for karma or upasana. Adhikari is separate, an individual adhikari. He is not there anymore. Therefore, karma upasana adini nirarthakani syuhu. Karma and upasanas which are revealed by the Vedas will become useless, purposeless. At least we should say they have no purpose, which is in a rude language, it would be useless. Jivecha brahma swarupantar bhava apyubagame jiva bhava pannatvad brahmanah. Jivecha brahma swarupantar bhava apyubagame. So I think it is explained in an opposite manner. Rather, I explain it in an opposite manner. I do not know how he has landed on that meaning. Jivecha brahma swarupantar bhava abhyupagame. In jiva, if you see brahma swarupa, antar bhava, then what will happen? Jiva bhava pannatvad brahmana. Brahma will become jiva. Then upasya bhava, upasya abhava prasangaha. Then upasya will not be there. Right? This is hair splitting analysis. Whether you say jiva is Brahma or Brahma is jiva, either way, what will happen in one paksha? Since aikya is there, there is no adhikari. Jiva is Brahma, there is no adhikari. Brahma is jiva, there is no upasya. So, somehow, I mean, I have taken it another way. Somehow, to me at least, it does not make sense. Jivecha Brahma swarupantar bhava abhyupagame. Since in jiva you are expecting Brahma Rupa, then jiva has become Brahma. However, he is saying jiva bhava apannatvat brahmana. He is taking the other way around. So perspectives are reversed. not much of a difference. Perspectives are reversed, but we have to understand this in this way. In whether you take Jiva as Brahma or Brahma as Jiva, what will happen? If Jiva attains Brahmatvam, then there is no Brahma separate, so there will be no Upasya. Upasya Brahma is not there. How will you do Brahma Upasana if Brahma is not separate from you? So Upasya Abhava Prasangaha. And in the earlier case, what have we seen? If Brahma becomes Jiva, then what will happen? Karma and Upasana. Jiva is Brahma. Then Karma and Upasana, Adhikari will not be there because Jiva is already Brahma. Thereby, either way you look at it, you will either not have Adhikari in one case, because Brahma is, if Brahma himself is Jiva, let me put it in a simpler manner. I don't want to go in this which attribute is taken for what. So whether Jive Brahmatvam or Brahmani Jivatvam, we can see it that way, but then the concepts are a little different. Different from what my understanding is here of the sentences. Somehow that way is not working out. So let me put it in other ways. Another way to see it is, if Jiva is Brahma, then Jiva lacking, there is no Adhikari. So Karma Upasana Adhikari missing, there cannot be Karma Upasana teaching. But it is there, therefore it is useless. Now, if Jiva is Brahma, then Brahma separately is not existing, then what will happen? There will be no Upasya Brahma separate. Thereby, Upasana Karma is also not possible. Therefore, Upasya Abhava Prasanga iti Upasana Vakyani Nishphalani Syuhu. So, Adhikari Abhavat, Karma is not possible. And then, due to Upasya Abhava, Upasana is not possible. Apicha Karma Phala Dhatuhu Ishwarasya Abhavat Karma Anushthanam Api Nishphalam Syat. Further, what will happen? There will be no Ishwara separate. Since when you say Jiva and Brahma are one, you mean Ishwara is one with Jiva. Thereby, what will happen? Ishwara is not there separately. Therefore, Ishwarasya Abhavat Karma Anushthanam Api Nishphalam Syat. There will be no one to give you phala. You yourself are Ishwara. So there is no possibility of karma also, because karma phala data is not there. Karmatirikta Ishwara Nasti Svatantram Karmeva Phalam Dadati Iti Mimamsakokti Rapina Yujyate. Purva Mimamsakas say that we don't need Ishwara. They don't accept Ishwara. Purva Mimamsakas Karma Kandi say that Ishwara is not needed. Karma has Mantra Shakti. Mantras are used in karma. That karma is revealed by the Shruti through mantras. The Mantra Shakti itself will give result. It is Mimamsaka. Karmaya phalam dadati. That karma itself will give result. That is not right. Why? Because karma is jada, jadatvat karmanaha. So you need Ishwara, but Ishwara is one with you. So Ishwara is not separate. If Ishwara is not separate, there is no karma phala data. If there is no karma phala data is there, then karma will not yield results, because karma is jada. So you need chetana separate to give you results. Nahi jadasya karmanaha phaladatrutva rupa samarchyam ghatate. It cannot give phala. Ataha sarvajnyadeva ishwarat karma phala siddhir vachya. So karma phala is given by Ishwara as a karma phala data, who is sarvajnya, who knows each and every karma of each and every jiva. Tasma jivatma paramatmanor ekatvam yujyata iti. Therefore, this shanka that I have is valid. Jiva and Paramatma cannot be one. Why? Because the so many Bheda Vakyas have been taught first in the Upanishad itself. Karma and Upasanas have been taught. Adhikari is there. Otherwise, the karma teaching will be invalid. Upasya Devata should be there separate from you. Otherwise, Upasana Vidhi is not valid as taught by the Shruti. It will be useless. Then Ishwara, who is karma phala data, has to be separate from you. If he is not separate, then who will give you results? If you say karma will give results, karma is jada, it cannot give results. Therefore, Sarvajna Ishvara should be there, who is separate from you, who can give karma phala, who has taught through Vedas, he has taught karma and upasanas, and this Dvasuparna ityadi mantras have also been taught. Therefore, tasma jivatma paramatmanor ekatvam yujyata iti ayancha pramanagata samshaya. This is pramanagata samshaya. Shruti is not teaching aikya. This is pramanagata samshaya, and earlier prameyagata samshaya, which is what? This aikya which is revealed by the Shruti cannot be so. So both this pramanagata samshaya will go by inquiry into Shruti, which is Shravana, and Manana will take away Prameyagata Samshaya, as Aikya is not applicable. It cannot be, it is not applicable to me. So, which was taught earlier as Prameyagata Samshaya. Prameyagata Samshaya. So, we'll continue in the next part. Sukannityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurupe Adhishtanam Buddhya Buddhyam Buddhya Drukyatya Nirvana Param Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Param Tadeva Anvattu Nitti Me Nishchitamati Hi. Sorry, I'm already late for the class. I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Very good.